Welcome back to the Northbourne Repair Cafe online channel. Today we've just got a very short video for you, showing you how you can test your amplifier, your secondhand amplifier that you just picked up, to make sure it doesn't blow your speakers. It's very easy for this to happen. There's lots of faults in amplifiers that could make this occur, but using a multimeter, we can do some quick checks just before you connect up those speakers. Anyway, I hope it's useful for you. So it's a pretty common situation. You find yourself with a secondhand amplifier that you bought cheaply off eBay or Gumtree or something like that, or one of your neighbours, and you think you'll just take it home and connected to your speakers at home. What I'd like to do is give you a couple of things to check before you actually connect to the speakers to help save your speakers from potentially being damaged. All you need is a multimeter. Now, you don't need anything fancy at all. I'm showing you one I use in my office here at the moment. It's nothing special, you can use any multimeter you like, as long as you can measure voltage, DC voltage, which they all do, and you need to use it in its lowest possible settings. So I'll just rearrange this amplifier so that you can see the bits that we need to test. So you can see I've now turned the amplifier around to show you the back face, and also to just make sure I reinforce the point, there is nothing connected to the inputs and there's no speakers currently connected. We don't want to do that yet until we've done the test. So the amplifier is actually turned on, and what we're going to measure, and the important bit about this video, is to measure what's called the DC offset. And the DC offset is basically the measurement, the DC voltage measurement on the terminals of the speaker. So in this case, I'm measuring the left channel, and the DC offset is measuring 0.027, 27 millivolts. And I'll go and do the same measurement on the right-hand channel, and that's about 20 millivolts. So it's as simple as that. Measure the voltage across the terminal for each of the channels with the amplifier turned on and with no inputs connected. Now, in fact, what you really should do is let the amplifier warm up for 5 or 10 minutes before you take these measurements. The measurements are likely to stabilize a bit better after 5 or 10 minutes. And so your measurements will be more representative of the DC offset for the amplifier. So why do we care about DC offset on amplifier outputs? Well, to explain it as, you know, in a very, very simple way, your speaker drivers are driven by oscillations or variations in the DC voltage that goes across the terminals. And if that is stuck at a higher level, then what it does is it drives the speaker cone to its limit, and it can actually cause current to run through the wires of the speaker and burn that out. And so it's to be avoided. Now, what's a safe level of DC offset? You can probably find lots of debate about that online. The rules of thumb I generally use is anything less than probably 35 to 40 millivolts, I think it's okay. If it's less than 10 millivolts, it's pretty darn good. If it's more than 100, I'd be starting to look at whether I need to do some adjustments or potentially do some repair of the amplifier. And certainly if it's in the several volts and up to maybe 30 or 40 volts, which is quite common if there's a particular failure in the amplifiers, then it's time to actually get in and do some repairs. So what you're looking for when you measure it, and as you saw the numbers for this amplifier a bit earlier, they're around the 20 to 25 millivolts. I'm happy that this is a safe amplifier to connect to my speakers, and I would continue on with further testing and enjoying the music. So anyway, I hope this is useful, and if you've got any questions, please send them through. And if you like the video, if it's useful for you, please give us a thumbs up down below, and we'll look forward to giving you more of these sort of advice videos. Thank you again, and thank you for coming to our Northbourne Repair Cafe YouTube channel.